Welcome to the ET-335-7447 7-segment decoder presentation.
Hello, this is the lecture on 7-segment LED displays and the 7447 BCD to 7-segment decoder. This here is a display of 7 segments. They have 7 LED 7 segments, and they're labeled A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. So it goes clockwise, the F, and then we have G. Sometimes they have 1, 2, or 0 decimal points, and these are the displays, the LEDs, which will light to make the numbers to 0 to 9. And here we have where we display the numbers, where the X. Okay, here's the displays that we use to do hexadecimal representations A through F. We use these on our 8085 trainer for ET420, and this is just a way to make new digits. This is a diagram of the two different types of 7-segment displays. We have a common anode, where we have a common positive voltage to the anode, and we provide a ground to the segments in order to light them. Okay, here's a common cathode, where we have a common ground goes to the cathode, and we use positive values in order to light the segments. This is the 7447 BCD layout for binary input, BCD 0 to 9, and we put the binary weighted positive values in here. And internally, it actually selects the segments which are required in order to display. It does display beyond 9, but it's got some strange characters that come out. It's basically designed for 0 to 9. Here's a diagram of the 7447 device showing some of the functions it could do. On pin 3, if we pull it low, LT means light test. All 7 segments will light up. It's a way to test the LEDs. Okay. If we pull pin 4 low, we get a blanking input. Okay, that means that no display under any condition, no matter what we put into the BCD. Light test is the same thing. Once light test is pulled low, it'll stay at 8 and ignore all the other signals. Then we have RBI. If this one pulls low, this is a ripple blanking input, which means if we display a 0, or if we get a 0 code come in, it will not display the 0. It's for blanking out zeros on displays that we don't want the 0 to show. When this guy is low and we get a 0, we're going to get an RBO out, which we're going to feed to the next device. This is showing leading zero suppression function. So if we put the RBI low and the first digit is a 0 and we don't want it to display, it will not display. Okay, it'll be blanked. Since this one's 0 and RBI is low, we're going to send a low signal to the next device. It will no longer display a 0. And now we have a clean display. Instead of 0039, we're going to get a blank 39. Since this guy is 0 and this RBI is low, it's going to send a low to this one. Since this segment is not a 0, it's going to display. Since this one's low, this is not 0, we're going to send a high to the next RBI, and it's going to display. Here's the other function of the ripple blanking. Here we want to blank out the trailing digits. So we're going to put a low into RBI at the least significant digit. It's 0, so RBO is going to be 0, which is going to go to the next RBI. Its input is 0, so it's going to blank. Alright, since its RBI is low and it's 0, we're going to send a low out to the next RBI. Since this digit is not 0, it is going to display, and it is going to send a high to the next RBI, so even if it's a zero, the zero will display. Here's a functional diagram, a basic circuit where it shows how the device works. We have inputs, digital inputs, which will go to our displays for the LED. If it's a zero, we're going to get an input into our OR gate. Okay, since it's zero, it's going to put a low out. We have a low. If we have RBI high, it's going to go high, which is going to send a blanking RBO high out, so that the next digit will not zero out. If we move this to low RBI, we are going to get a zero out of here, which is going to send a zero to RBI, so the next device is going to be low when we have a zero. Here we show resistor packs. We have two different types. We have a SIP, a single inline package, and we have a dual inline package. This is the device we're going to use when we use 7-segment displays. Instead of using 7 independent resistors, we're going to use a IC that has them built in. They come in all kinds of different configurations. The one we want to use is the straight across. Both of these devices can be bused like this. This would be an option that if we wanted to put separate LEDs, and ground it, we could use this as a common ground. Or we could put a positive in here and use it as a common positive.